Let's learn how to make a simple line graph in Excel whereby each category or time interval has only one numeric value. Step 1 is to enter and format your source data. Whether the source data is entered in row or column format, the time intervals, that would be the days, months, years, or in this case 15-minute intervals, should be listed first. That's because we want them to show up on the horizontal or x-axis of the graph. The variable that's being measured should be listed next. In this case, it's the number of incoming calls to our contact center. This will appear on the y-axis of our graph. Step 2 is to make sure that a line graph is right for your data type. We know that line graphs are useful for showing trends over time because psychologically, we tend to associate linear images with time. And that works here because we want to see the trend or pattern of calls that come in to our contact center. Step 3 is to highlight the data and insert the desired chart. So we select the data. And if the two columns that you're using as your source data aren't next to each other, just hold down the Control key in between selections. Then we go to the Insert tab and choose a chart from the Charts command group. Since we're doing line graphs, we click on this icon, and there are quite a few options for single line graphs like 2D, 3D, 2D area, and 3D area. Area charts are also considered types of line charts, whereby the area below the line is shaded to highlight the volume of change over time. But for your first chart, we suggest to go with either the classic 2D line or the 2D line with markers. Once you click the icon, your chart is inserted on the worksheet. A multiple line graph in Excel is one where the independent variables on the x-axis have several data points. When you're making a multiple line graph, the first column or row of data should be your time measurement, just like we had before with the single line charts, and each subsequent column or row will represent the series which will be plotted. The individual cells will contain the respective values. So our 1, 2, 3 steps are the same. 1, we've just formatted our data. 2, since we're comparing the number of calls coming in at different consecutive intervals, this will form a timeline, so a line chart is appropriate for this type of data. And step 3 is to highlight the source data, go to Insert, and click the chart type. So here let's go back to our line chart with markers, and it's inserted on our worksheet. As before, the time intervals show up on the x-axis and the numerical measurements on the y-axis. Each series is shown as a line in its own color on the graph, and a legend was created to identify which series is represented by each color. Now you can customize your graph by adding or removing elements in the usual way. From the green chart elements shortcut next to the chart, we can click on that, and this will allow us to add axis titles, data labels, and other types of elements. So let's say we wanted to include an axis title only for the horizontal axis. And we wanted to call this the intervals. Notice that the name is being typed in the formula bar, and when we hit enter, it shows up as the axis title. We can also name our chart title by clicking on this placeholder and just typing in the name that we'd like to have for this chart. So let's say we wanted to call this incoming calls by interval and enter. And that becomes our chart title. We can make cosmetic changes by clicking on the paintbrush icon next to the chart. So if we click on this, it allows us to change the style of the graph. Or we can make changes to the color scheme. If you want to kind of go rogue and change a single element within the plot area of the chart, let's say you didn't like this series color, and you just wanted to change this maybe to green. You can select this series, go to the Format tab, and click on Shape Outline. change this to green, and this series color is changed, and the legend is also updated. Or a simpler way to do this, let's undo. We could just right-click on this element and change the outline here. If the element that you want to customize is a text element, like it's in the axis or the legend area, you can select it and change it from the Home tab. So what if we wanted to change this maybe to italics? Then it's done here. And if we wanted to make the axis title bold, we can click on bold here or use the regular shortcut, Control B, and it's done. Line charts are some of the most commonly used Excel charts, so you should get comfortable using them. Download the practice file and let us know what you think in the comments.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.